हाय डियर स्टूडेंट, हाउ आर यू? डियर स्टूडेंट, टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट नॉन न्यूट्रिटिव कंपोनेंट्स ऑफ डाइट. सो आई थिंक दैट यू हैव रीड ऑलरेडी अबाउट द न्यूट्रिटिव डाइट, बट नाउ यू हैव टू रीड नॉन न्यूट्रिटिव डाइट, नॉन न्यूट्रिटिव कंपोनेंट ऑफ डाइट. And what are the importance of these non-nutritive component of diet? So you have to read about the in this topic. First of all, you have to read about water. So our body consists of approximately 70% of water in our body weight. An adult needs 2 to 3 liters water daily for normal life. In summers, body need more water due to the sweating, etc. The person who does hard physical activity also need more water. It means in this condition, we have to need more than 2-3 liters. So, depend on the season, like in summer season, we have to need more than 2-3 liters. And when we are performing any hard physical activity, at that time we have to need the more water, more than 2-3 liters. The water which we drink should be safe, clean and hygienic. If the water in body is reduced, it causes serious health problem like loss of 1-5% of water result thirst. So when we are feeling thirstiness, at that time from our body 1-5% water has been lost. If the water loss of 5-10% of water result loss of strength and endurance. When we lose the percentage of water 5-10%, that time we feel loss of strength and endurance. Loss of 10-15% of water result dehydration, lethargy, body pain. So these conditions we can suffer if we lose the water percentage 10-15%. Now loss of the water percentage 15-20% of water result blurred vision, loss of memory, faint. So in this condition, if we lose 15-20% of water from our body, and that time our eyes effect will be there, blurred vision, loss of memory, and we feel faint, giddiness. Next, loss of the more than 20% of water result death. If from our body, if 20% of water will be lost, that time can be the serious problem, maybe death also. So you know that what is the importance of water. So from daily basis we should drink more than 2-3 liter water. It's very important for us. And which water we are drinking, that water should be safe, clean and hygienic. So I think that we should drink water after 1 hour, one glass water after 1 hour. So in this condition we can drink 2-3 liters whole a day. So now student, you have to read now the importance of water. Water plays important role in our body. So already you have read about that, something importance of the water. Now you have to read about the what is the work of water in our body. So first of all, regulate body temperature. So in our body, the first work of the water help to maintain and regulate the body temperature by sweating, etc. So our body sweating, and that time water regulate and maintain the body temperature of the body. Second, transportation of nutrition. So water in body helps to transport important nutrients through the blood. Water in body also act as solvent for carrying important nutrients. So water, what is the work of the water? Transportation of nutrients. So that's why water is very important for us. Next, maintain body fluid. Water helps to maintain body fluids in body. It helps in digestion, absorption, circulation, creation of saliva, etc. So these are the main work of the water. It helps the to digestion of our food, absorption, nutrition from our food, circulation of the blood, creation of saliva, etc. So creation of saliva, you know that all time our tongue create the saliva. So this saliva is creating by water. If we will take regular water, then our saliva glands can be create the in proper proportion saliva. Now eliminates body toxins. So eliminate body toxins. It helps to eliminate the body toxins and body waste through the exertion of urine and sweating, etc. So the in our body, the many toxins form in our body, and water, only the water can eliminate these all toxins from the body and body waste through the exertion of urine and sweating, etc. Next, lubrication of joints. So it helps in lubrications of joint, thus improve flexibility and joining mobility. So it also the make the help for the lubrication of every joint of our body, and this joint improve the flexibility and joint mobility can be better. So that's the water also help for the mobility of joint and flexibility, improve the flexibility. Next, improve the skin quality. So sufficient water in body help to keep the skin looking good and beautiful. So you know that everyone want to become good and beautiful skin, so we should drink in proper proportion of the water. Now kidney function improve. Water help to clean kidneys and thus their function improve. So you know that the main work of the kidney, it can purify our blood, and also the water also help to the kidney, and thus the function of improve the kidney function can be improved. Next, maintains electrolyte balance. So it helps to maintain electrolyte balance in body, thus the impulses travel faster. So what impulses working in our body that can travel faster, moreover faster response can be formed. So the maintain the electrolytes balance can be improved by the water. Next, boost physical performance. So sufficient water help to boost the physical performance, whereas the loss of water reduce performance. So you know that water improve our strength and range. So that's why we can better performance in any sports or in any activities. So physical performance can be improved by the water. So it's also boost the physical performance. Next, improve digestion. So water help to improve the digestion and absorption, moreover prevent constipations. So water improve our digestion. You know that the digestion work from start our mouth and saliva glands also. Saliva that making digestion work from the our mouth and continuous working in our up to the our small intestine. So and absorption, so in small intestines absorption work also done by the water, and moreover prevention of constipation. So constipation, you know that our intestines can be dry at that time, the water can prevent from the constipation disease. So dear student, I think that you have understood about the importance of water, what are the role in our body of the water, you have read now. Now you have to read about roughage or fiber. So roughage is also the non-nutritive diet in our food. So roughage, also known as fiber, is indigestible portion of food. So mainly the fiber or roughage, indigestible portion of food. Fiber comes from the part of plants based food that body cannot digest. It is an essential dietary component that aids in digestion, prevents constipation, and help to manage cholesterol level. So these roughage also component that aid in digestion and prevent constipation and help to manage cholesterol level. So cholesterol level can be managed by the roughage and fiber, and we can prevent us from the constipation. Constipation, which means the our intestine into the lack of the water, to the lack of the roughage, that time the constipation can be held in our intestine. So that at that time the fiber can prevent us from the constipation disease. Most of the vegetables and fruit contain high fiber along with the nutritional value. Legumes, nuts, grains, seeds also contain fibers food. So fiber has no nutrients value, add bulk to the food and satisfy the appetite. These are the importance of roughage and fiber. So we should take proper amount of the fiber, and we can get the fiber from the legumes, nuts, grains, seeds, and contain the fibrous foods. Most of the vegetables and fruits. So it's also very important, and it can also prevent the different kinds of disease, like manage the cholesterol level and can prevent the constipation. Now, dear student, you have to read about the flavor compound. So flavor are the derived from the both nutritive and non-nutritive compound of the food. Acidic food provide sour taste, and alkaline food provide bitter taste. And plants contain other non-nutritive substance. Tea, coffee contains caffeine. So these are also the non-nutritive diet, but we also take in different way in our flavor, just like this in many kinds of flavors and colored and acidic food improve our sour taste, alkaline food provide bitter taste, and tea, coffee, we daily routine we take, and they contain the caffeine. So that's why we should not take tea, coffee in much portion. So now we have to read about the artificial sweeteners and preservatives. So dear student, you have listened about the artificial sweeteners and preservatives, the many kinds of the food preserve by the preservatives items. So these are the low or no calorie and provide sweet taste. These are usually taken by the diabetic persons. So artificial sweeteners only taken by the diabetic person as an alternative to nutritive sweeteners. So this is only the alternative of the to the nutritive sweeteners. Many times packing of the food stuff for the long time require adding of preservative. So you know that many times packing of the food, mostly you know that the many kinds of food coming in the market in the different kinds in wrapper food, you can say that food stuff to the for long time require adding to the preservative. So these food can be preserved for the long time by the in these preservatives in food. It helps to store food for the long time. So why these preservatives food can be stored for the long time? The preservatives are non-nutritive food and used in food industry. So preservatives, these are the non-nutritive food. The whatever packed food coming in the market that packed and preserved by the preservatives then are non-nutritive food and used in the food industry. These preservatives used by the food industries. So we should take the good quality preservatives should be used. That's why if we will want to the preserve our food, then that time we should use the good quality of preservatives food. So students, you know that today many students, children, they like to eat the mostly market food like the chips and this toffee, chocolates, many things they are coming in the market. Then most these all things are preserved by these preservatives. So I think that we should not eat in much way these all wrappers food. If possible, then we should take the only the home cooked food and we avoid these all market wrappers food. So I think that you have understood about the artificial sweeteners and preservatives, but what are the work of the preservatives and artificial sweeteners. So dear student, today I have taught you about the non-nutritive diet in our food which we are take in different way. So I think that you have understood and whatever work I have completed and whatever topic I have taught you, please you complete and show me. Okay, thank you.